Today's project is this gas power compressor. It came as a package deal in the back of this 1968 Dodge service truck that I bought basically for scrap price. They were just going to get rid of it. And I was mostly interested in this compressor, but I got the truck running too. But that's in a different video. Anyway, I don't know a ton about these Kohler motors, but it says it's US made. My guess is it's from the 80s. Could be wrong, but let's check it out. I was looking at some of these serial tags and I noticed 9 of 78 for the tank, and I assume that means 1978. I also noticed 8 of 78 here, and then I was reading the serial number here. It looks like it's a K241S. I looked that up and that means it's a 10 horsepower motor, and it has a 7-digit serial. From what I know, the first two numbers indicate the year. This says 91, but I don't know if that's accurate or not. You guys let me know. Take a peek here inside the gas tank. Has some fuel in it. Hard to see, but there is a little bit of sediment in there too. Has compression and turns over. Looks like here's the oil fill. I thought there should be a dipstick right here. Maybe that's a different model. It looks like here's the oil drain. Looks like it has push button start and a kill switch. Air filter here. I assume this shuts down the throttle once it's full of air. Got the gauge. Looks like they have an air shut off. Still holds a little bit of air. I'll leave that closed. The first few things I'm going to do is change out this old spark plug, check the oil, and drain the gas, put fresh stuff in. I don't know when the last time this was ran, but the truck sat unused since about 2012. So I assume that this wasn't used any more recently. Don't look too bad. It's a Atlas SE10. I believe the factory one was a Champion RH10. Got this Autolite 216, which is the same thing as a Champion RH10, gap to 0.030.
Alright, gonna check the oil here. Came off nice and easy. Looks like it has a dipstick on the fill hole. That would make sense. It's a little bit low, definitely old. But that should be enough. Just see if it'll fire anyway, then I'll change the oil later. I'm going to use my little vacuum pump to help me siphon out the gas. I'm using a milk jug to hold the old gas for now.
Alright, the fuel's drained out. You truck drivers might think this looks like a piss jug. And it might be a piss jug, but it's got gas in it this time. Anyway, found this cable here. Looks like it connects to the starter. So I'm going to follow it up front under the hood, see if it connects to the battery. Here's the wire, and looks like it connects right here. So let's take this off. Let's stick this one on. All right, let's see what it's gonna do.
Alright, see if it has spark.
Well, I tested for spark and it has none. There's the condenser, and this is the points cover. Comes off of the screw there, and a screw right here.
Inside the cover, there's corrosion, so that's a sign that the points have corrosion too.
Yeah, the points are pretty gummed up. You take it off with this screw here, and then there's another one down below. And then this screw is how you adjust the points after you have it cleaned. Here you can see how nasty they are. I'm gonna get some sandpaper and clean them up. There's really nothing much to clean in points. You see that there's corrosion on them. I just take sandpaper. This happens to be 220 grit. Fold it in half. And open up the points. Just sand it back and forth. You'll get residue off each time. You can see how they're kind of shiny now. Just gonna clean them off with some brake clean and go and reinstall them. This screw right here, when you're setting your points, you wanna set them to about 18 thousandths. That's 0.018. And you just loosen this when the points are open to their maximum gap, and you'll close it by moving it in. If it's already too tight, then you just pry it back. I'll show you that when it's on the machine. All right, I'm going to turn the motor over by hand until the points open up. That looks like about as wide as they're going to get. Have my feeler gauge, 18 thousandths. And it's pretty much already good. Don't have to do anything to it. If I did have to, just loosen this here, and then it moves back and forth. This whole piece here moves back and forth. Well, we got a runner, so I'm gonna see how much air it'll build, make sure everything shuts off like it's supposed to. I turned it off early because I wanted to make sure the kill switch worked. So here we go. Looks like it shut down automatically at about 135 PSI. Over here, that's a shutoff valve and a hose, so I'm gonna see if I can pump up a tire with it. Thank you. probably enough air for these old bias ply tires. 35 PSI. We have a working compressor, and I bought a truck with a compressor that pumped up its own tires. Well, I couldn't be happier with how this turned out. Got a free air compressor that runs now. All I needed was the points clean, really, and the new gas, of course, and a super cheap Dodge to go with it. So I'd say I really lucked out. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps me out a lot since I am a new YouTuber, and you can see me build and work on quite a few other projects. But anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.